Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. And, well, we've been asked by Evelyn to basically betray Dex and keep him out of the loop. Therefore, I would get more money, but then, well, Dex would be pissed. Sure, he'd find out about it. Maybe we can call Jackie and ask what he thinks. And how do I? Things are not moving. Oh, okay. What can I arrow down? Like, okay. Calling Jackie. Hopefully he answers.
Hmm? How's it going?
I don't get to ask him. I want to ask him about this with Dex and Evelyn. Have I asked him this before? How well do you know T-Bug?
Hey, how well do you know Bug exactly?
That mamita got a soft spot for me.
Think so?
No, but seriously, she ain't the type you go out and rub her with. Don't actually think she got any soft spots anywhere.
Oh.
Or anybody.
That's a weird effect.
Right.
How's Mama Wells?
How's your mom?
Shh. Worried about me. Been for a while.
Something happened?
Started climbing our way up. Got more knives out there. We need to step up on the back.
What's with the reverb?
Higher stakes, higher risk. She can see that.
I don't think it's supposed to sound like that. And, you and Misty, are you serious?
Been with Misty a while, huh?
Yeah, about a year. Why?
Just asking. Never thought you'd last that long in a stable, healthy relationship.
Hey, come on, Chica. You know I was raised right.
I'll catch you later.
All right, I'm out. Take care.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, something's weird with that connection. Can I talk to anyone else about it? Can I talk to T-Bug? No answer. My life coach? What are these people, sleeping or something? Evelyn Parker.
You need something?
What do you know about Dex?
What do you know about Dex DeShawn?
Best fixer in town. Found exactly who I needed, faster than the rest. And asked the fewest questions. Too bad his mercs don't follow his lead.
Heh. How long do you know Judy? I got more questions.
You know Judy a while?
Why does that matter to you?
Doesn't. Just curious.
I trust her. She won't betray us. I think that's all you need to know.
And answer my question. Why do we meet at the Mox Club?
Why'd you set up the meeting at Lizzie's?
Good a place as any.
You linked to the Mox somehow?
Yes. We share a fondness for discretion.
Hmm. Alright, later.
Talk later.
Don't let me down, V.
Eh. Depends on what you consider being let down. Victor.
Hmm.
How's Biz? I asked him that before.
Have a good one.
See you around, B.
I just called you to tell you that. Don't forget to have a good one. Did something bad happen to her? I might have forgotten. Okada. She has some jobs for us. Alright. Now I think if we... Does that regen our points? Yes. So I don't have to use that inhaler thing. I guess we're gonna go. Stealing their car?
Well, too much.
Too much, huh? Oh, I'm on the wrong side of the road. Got a green light. Oh, I'm going through a red light now. Oh, it just turned green. We have to pay the price. This canvas with two faces. A full nature of love and loss. You will some passion for the ages. And in the end, just pay the cost. A thing of beauty, I know. Is there a street going that way? Pardon me. So what you have to say, what a thing of beauty. We'll never fade away. I'm just learning how to drive. Give me a break. We'll never fade away. We'll never fade away.
I see your eyes, I know you see me. You're like a ghost, I run. What are you doing?
I'm a demon. Running into you. Button again? That's not it. I keep forgetting how to get out of the damn car. Yeah, I've been pressing that. There we go. You gotta hold it down, I guess. I'm a better pedestrian than driver. Alright, to the afterlife we go. Except it's... There's like no shoulder here. Oh, here we go. Afterlife, this is a hotel. These people are dragging their feet, some of them. Afterlife entrance.
No. Que ya tengo planes para esta noche. Santísima ma. Te vas a enterar mañana.
Oh.
Yo también te quiero, ma.
I knew I heard you.
About time, chica.
How's mama?
What's new with Senora Wells?
You know, she's worried about me. Whatever. Hmm. Can't help herself, you know? Checking to see if I'm not rotting in some dumpster, like most of the Wells boys. It's really starting to wear on me. The more I tell her everything's okay, the more I feel like I'm straight up lying.
We'll be okay.
But that's done after tomorrow. Afterlife, here we come, baby. Yeah!
Doesn't look all it's bigged up to be.
Funny.
What?
For a club with the hottest contracts in town, doesn't look like all it's bigged up to be.
It's what's inside that counts, Chum.
True, but...
Ready to get your cherry popped? Yeah, come on!
What's up here?
The fuck was that?
That's me, wondering what the hell is up there.
The place used to be a morgue. Believe that?
Who would have thunk?
For real?
I know, right? Way before our time, that. The proper burials were still a thing.
The struggle of O'Neill Station. The European Space Agency, ESA, started out with seemingly noble intentions, will open the door to the universe, the solar system, a home to all, and so on and so forth. It didn't take long for these catchphrases to reveal themselves of what they truly were. Colonial ambitions wrapped up in lofty ideals. We, the builders and first inhabitants of O'Neill 1, have witnessed this firsthand. The ESA sent us into space with promises of a new life and a better tomorrow. Instead, what lay in wait for us was a complete lack of freedom and back-breaking work in extremely dangerous conditions. We would have pulled through, we would have toughed it out for the greater good, if only they treated us as human beings, informed us of their decisions, listened to our concerns and requests, but the ESA ignored us. The consequences were inevitable. In 2022, after completing construction of the station, our situation was critical. Station management demanded 18 hours of work every day, 7 days a week, from everyone, regardless of age or health condition. Our peaceful protest was met with a disproportionate use of force, which included stun guns. They thought it would break us, just like the countless protests they broke back on Earth. The thing is, out here it's not so easy to call for reinforcements. Workers outnumbered guards 40-1, and one stun gun charge held only 15 rounds. The ESA's management had effectively shot themselves in the foot. It was over before they could realize. Only 7 hours passed before O'Neill 1 and O'Neill 2 declared independence and became the first nations established outside of Earth. That's awesome. Yeah, I'm very interested in this, these outer world colonies. Or, not outer world, but solar system colonies, I suppose you call it? What's that? What is that? There's something there. The legs are in the way. Whatever.
And who might you clowns be?
Well, I'm Bozo the Clown, and this is Clarence the Clown. Friends of Dexter DeShawn.
We're friends of Dexter DeShawn. He's expecting us.
Yo, Dex. Got two live ones saying they're here to see you.
Yeah, we're not dead.
Yeah? All right, then. Says he needs a second or two. Go get yourselves drinks or something.
Well,
way ahead of you, viejo.
What's viejo mean?
This is it. Best leave ever. Jordan Night City. That's it right there. Beating. Hear it?
Is
Can
it?
Can you imagine? Susan Forrest, Boa Boa. Maybe even Morgan Blackhand. All sat on those stools.
Oh, Boa.
Sleep on that same bar.
Looks like we're up.
Hey, you see that old lady there? That's Rogue. Best fixer in all of Night City.
That... Thought Dex was the best.
Rogue was lining up jobs when Dex was still shitting in diapers. The place belongs to her.
So the one I barely turned to see. Jackie, you pick for me.
You order.
Two tequila old fashions with a splash of cerveza and a chili garnish.
That's interesting.
Duo of Johnny Silverhands coming up.
Is that what they call it?
Right on, chica.
I'd actually like to try that in real life.
Somebody did their homework.
It's like the dog ate mine.
Age-old tradition. Drinks are named after our regulars.
What do you have to do to get a drink named after you?
Say I wanted to have a drink named after me. What would I have to do?
Snuff it. Mind-blowingly spectacular fashion. Mid-op would be best.
I think I'll pass.
What a beautiful tradition.
That's a pretty steep price to pay.
Steep price to pay for a drink.
Hey, everyone's gotta go sometime, right? Why not in style?
To this. Is that what I said to Jack, to Jackie before? To this? Yeah, let's do a better toast this time. To the heist of a lifetime.
To hitting the major leagues.
I'll drink to that. Oh, and by the way, name's Jackie Wells. You want to write down my recipe?
Sure.
Shot of vodka on the rocks, lime juice, ginger beer. Oh, and most importantly, a splash of love.
Ha ha! I'll remember that. Heard you were Dex's latest finds.
Just biz, no big deal.
You hear stuff, huh?
Mr. DeShawn, see you now.
How'd you know?
How'd you know?
My job to know. Look around. How do you think mercs earn their reps? Through gossip rivaling that of schoolgirls, that's how.
Is Dex a regular here?
Dex a regular? You come here a lot?
A sort of long hiatus, matter of fact. Didn't show his face for nearly 2 years.
Tomcat's gotta walk his own path, right?
Yeah, well, wherever he walked, he knocked a few pounds off.
Guess they weren't delivering that pizza I mentioned before.
Alright, well. Guy says he's ready for us, so.
Bad time to choke if she's rich as Joel.
Thanks.
Come on.
Be patient.
This way.
Talking about my britches.
Damn, Holmes. You're huge. Work out? Same here. No, in the ring. You do some kind of exotic shit? Huh? Kenpo? Ninjutsu? Think you could take me? Drop me?
In here.
Este pinche tipo.
Don't talk much, do you? I can't tell Jackie about what Evelyn...
That's right. Excelsior.
...wants us to cut him out.
Cold hard eddies, as per usual. Gotta bounce. Well, if it ain't Miss V.
Whole family in one place. Ha! Finally!
First time in real space.
The military.
And the flathead.
Oh, T-Bug!
I see this bad boy.
Hold on 1 second. Delamain Transport Services?
Now, don't be shy.
I'm just going to read this really quick. Or did I read this? This is new. Need to be on time for an important meeting? Don't want your valuable tech to fall into the wrong hands? Maybe you just don't like crowds. With Delamain, you leave your problems at the door. Our corporate transport service has a fleet of over 20 armored cars ready and waiting to bring you to your destination in comfort and security. We guarantee secure transport for individuals and packages in the Night City area, quality that goes hand-in-hand with speed, professional customer service, specifications to suit even the most demanding clients, and discounts for loyal customers. They say that most accidents happen in the home. They're wrong. Did you know that over 82% of crimes and accidents happen on the streets? Thanks, Adelamine. You'll never have to worry about statistics again. Our clients' comfort and security is our number one priority. We hold all safety requirement certificates. We don't ask questions. There's no sound more beautiful than the symphony of hostile bullets bouncing off our armored windows. Try the Excelsior package and enjoy our maximum security option. Safety is the one luxury you can afford, so what are you waiting for? Order Delamain today. Delamain, leave your problems at the door. Okay. So I might want to use their services at some point, so I just wanted to read about that. Here you go. I put it there, yes. Okay.
All right, then. Set your butts down comfy.
Thanks for your help with the scavs, Bug.
Thanks for your help back at the scav hunt.
A few Reapers less in the city. Good thing.
City Hall should be fucking thanking us.
Where do I sit? Oh, there's a seat here. Okay. Didn't see that.
Sweet booth. It's soundproof?
There's another shard.
Tacky.
Now, Mr. Wells is right. We're gonna be going over some sensitive material. But if it's all right with y'all, I'd like to start with a question for Miss V.
Oh, yeah?
Evelyn Parker, how'd you fare?
Yeah, my character had a lot of misgivings. I wish I could ask Jackie about this. But you don't just do that. You don't cut a fixer out, is what she said. It's just not done. And the way Evelyn just didn't give us a lot of details, things we asked for, she told us that we don't need to know, blah, blah, blah. I don't really trust her. If she was completely forthcoming with everything, every detail, you know, because you never know when something's going to come up on a job, something that you know, both of us could not, you know, foresee. I need to know as much information as possible. So if she had told me everything, then maybe. But, yeah, I don't trust her. And why does she want to keep him out of the loop? She said I would get more money. But what does it matter to her if she gives me some money and Dex some money? Right? I don't know if she explained that either. Either way, she's giving out money. Unless it would just cost her more with keeping, you know, paying Dex as well. So, I don't know. I'm gonna tell him.
Miss V?
Yeah, I'm just thinking. Didn't go bad, but Evelyn wants to cut you loose.
Couldn't have gone better. In fact, she liked me so much, she made me another offer.
Another offer?
Uh-huh. Kind where we ditch the middleman and split the pot in even 50-50.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yep.
Ditch the middleman? Shit, now that's rich. Client, you never learn.
Jackie.
Do they? I do appreciate you sharing this info, though, Miss V. You see, trust is essential in any partnership that's to be long-lasting and fruitful.
That's true. Thought you'd be pissed off.
Thought you'd be pissed that you'd lose it.
Lived in NC too long to blow my top every time some amateur thinks they can take me for a ride. Parker ain't the first, and sure as hell won't be the last.
I'm not sure what this means, that he doesn't appreciate me. Yeah. Let's go over the job.
How about we go over the plan? What you got for us, Dex?
This.
What's this? Oh. Let's have a look.
Well, here goes nothing.
Also, one I couldn't look at before.
Me and Dex have already covered the fine deep. Ops-wise, should be a stroll on the beach.
Elaborate. I want to hear it.
Adelamain will drop your asses at the front door of Kanpeki Plaza. You'll stroll right in thanks to your false identities. Then, with Bug's help, you'll breach the hotel subnet.
Mine and the Flathead's help.
Last but not least, You slip into Yorinobu's penthouse and klep the relic.
Goes without saying, we do this on the hush. Ideally, no bodies. Not a one.
You'll have T-Bug on comms for the duration. Time for your burning questions.
Delamine's our ride there and back, huh?
Transport to Delamine?
Primus cab company in all Night City. Not a mile.
DeShawn don't ever work with anyone but the best. I consider Delamine just that.
Yeah, who needs creepy, nosy cab drivers when you've got a clean AI to get you from point A to B in style?
And how he bags a permit to operate every year is still a mystery.
If everything goes as planned, Delamain will drop you back here. If things get sticky, you head for the safe house.
Okay.
Which is?
The No-Tell Motel. Quiet, no questions asked. Make our next move from there. But I'm flat certain that won't be necessary.
Okay.
Anything else?
Yeah, how do we get into the penthouse?
How do we get in the penthouse?
Yorinobu's got barely any muscle. Hardest part will be penthouse security. If we want to disable, we'll need to neutralize Konpeki's dweller. Elite runner monitoring the hotel subnet 24/7. Only catch is there's no way to get in the dweller's den from the outside.
Hold on. How you want us to get inside a room you can't get into?
Yeah.
Trust me when I say whatever hit you think of, T-Bug solved it already.
She's good.
This is where the flathead comes in. You'll have to get him in the ventilation shaft, guide him to the dweller, and force the dweller to take a break. Flathead will stay there, jacked into the dweller. But thanks to that, I'll be able to roll out your red carpet into the penthouse.
Anything else?
Okay. What kind of cover did you get for us?
These new identities. Tell us more, what's our cover?
Hello, Ramon Victorino. And you're Hannah Conwell.
He looks like a Victorino.
Ramon? Yeah, okay. What do we say we're there for?
Biz as usual. Corpo arms deal. In case anyone asks, you there for a bogus meeting with our Osaka's defense rep, Hajime Taki.
Taki.
Anything else?
Well, no more questions.
Okay. Bill brought up to speed.
Perfect.
I got a question. When do we get to the real reason we're all here?
Now's a good time as any. Fresh talent gets 30% always. But I'm willing to make an exception in your case. I'ma cut you a nice juicy 40 as a bonus for your honesty, D.
Nice. No, that the eddies are important. Sounds about right. Thanks.
That's more like it, Dex.
Ka-ching, baby.
Last thing. Konpeki's got a strict no iron policy. Security gates, the works. So you dogs will leave your lead spitters in the ride. Take the flathead inside in its case.
Got some death suits, so you'll look the part too.
Chido.
Thanks, T.
Wait.
So, not to count chickens, but why don't we see our eddies?
Is they saying no guns?
All depends how Miss Parker avails herself of her role. But a week, two tops is my guess.
And what do we do while waiting? Sit around, suck air.
You sit tight, heads down, because old Uncle Arasaka be watching. Now, as that old Greek dog says, life's a banquet, so don't go thirsty, but don't get drunk either. Your chariot awaits outside.
My cue to Delta 2. Got a prep to jack in. Be there when you come on comms. Any other issues, now's your chance.
Any thoughts on the plan?
Plan. What's your take?
Enough, I hope, to put me in a luxury Cretan villa from which I'll never set foot in cyberspace again.
Promise to send me a postcard?
No offense, but I'm gonna burn any and all bridges. Need a clean break.
Alright. What's the story with you and Dex?
You and Dex known each other a while.
Why?
Curious.
You know, peeps say all kinds of things.
Everything we hear is an opinion, not a fact. Marcus Aurelius, I think.
You and Dex, both philosophizing. No wonder you get along.
Yeah, I'm pretty clear in it, I think.
I'm good. No questions.
Let's get to work.
So you ready to get going or what?
Yeah, I guess something I gotta take care of first.
Something I gotta take care of first.
Sin problemas. Meet you by the Delamain.
Basically, I just want to look around a little. You got it? Alright, I was gonna grab it.
Just don't forget to suit up.
Your Delamain vehicle is waiting. Okay. Anything else new? This is what we're going to get. Did he just send this now? What was that before? Alright, so these are already looked at. Moon Explorer. Yeah, Regina is the one that I just saw. Yeah, don't mess over Regina. Yeah, I gotta look around the place. Oh, the outfit. Check out the new release, Brain Dances. Just want to make sure someone didn't read. What's up, BD maniacs? Hungry for a new emo rush? Then check out the latest word from the freshest BDs on the market. Foreign Body. The body is everything. There's nothing else. It is you, but it is also just a tool for your mind to interact with the world. What would happen if this tool tried to live its own life? What if it tried to kill you? Though not a particularly original addition to the thriller genre, this brain dance featuring Luke Poller is still a solid experiential ride. The fear of disobedient implants has been around since pirates were walking around on peg legs. I've read this one. Hold on, what do we see? It's in here somewhere, I think. I gotta look stupid in that hat, don't I? Main jobs, side jobs, gigs completed. Oh, we have a lot of things to do. Where did we... Put on the Militech suit? Is that what I'm supposed to be doing? I wasn't looking, I was looking for my shards. Alright, Put on the Militech suit. A typical, totally inconspicuous outfit for corporate agents. Cool.